Good morning, Morning Glory families. I wanted to show you today how to make to help your child to make their bunny ball. So in your materials bag, you should find a clump of white wool and a little rectangle of white felt, which we will cut later, cut the ears for. So first, from this clump of wool, you want to separate it into maybe two strips and just a little smidgen extra that we'll put on the tail after. So first, let's move this out of the way. First, you want to start with one of your strips. And this might be tricky to see because it's really something you feel with your fingers. But I share with the children, I sing one of our bread baking songs, rolling and rolling and rolling and rolling. And while you're rolling, you're also wanting to stretch it so that it's really very tight and snug. Otherwise, if it is too loose, when the children submerge it into their bath, then the wool will start to fall away. So you want to pull the fleece gently and then roll it and tuck it very firmly. You're really using your fingertips more than anything else with pressure. While we're singing, rolling and rolling and rolling and rolling. Stretching, and here we're stretching the wool just a little, but not too much. We don't want it to come apart. Stretching, boom, boom, boom. And with this first strip of wool, then you would have really formed this tight little inner core of the bunny ball's belly. And then, so we roll it up nice and snug. Nice and snug. Then we'll start with the other piece. So this first piece, it should be so tight that when I release it, it stays in a little nest. Now we've rolled one way, so we're going to roll. Now if your piece is very thick, then you might actually have a very fine piece for the finishing. And again, tucking it in under, rolling and tucking on the sides, and rolling, and all the while giving a little bit of pull to that fleece, but not too much. Rolling and rolling, stretching, stretching, boom, boom, boom. And then with the last piece, that's your finishing layer. Again, you give it a little test to know that that you can feel that nice, firm core in the middle. Okay. Now this piece is your last layer. And you're kind of pulling it gently over and over. And if it's long enough, you can go in the other direction. Stretching and stretching. Now, it's going to be nice and fluffy, but you want to make sure that you do have that really hard core inside. You can roll it just a little to shape it. And now I tell the children, a little bunny is going to hop into his bath. It's a nice warm bath. Now the bath should be as warm as the children can tolerate it. So you want to test that a little, make sure it's okay. You want to have them hold it in their little nest, as snug as a bug in a rug, I tell them. Otherwise it will start to fall apart and they can feel the bubbles, which they laugh. They can feel the bubbles. And when you feel like it's saturated all the way through, then we take just a few drops. Drop, drop, droppily properly, and they can start to roll it. And it's wonderful if they can do this, and maybe your hands are kind of that little veil on the outside helping them. But you can gauge if they really need help. If it's starting to fall apart, you want to come right in and help them with that so they don't get frustrated. Roly-poly rice ball, roll right in. Up the hill and down the hill and roll right in. Roly-poly rice ball, roll right in. Up the hill and down the hill and roll right in. Now, every once in a while, you want to ask them, oh, I hear pitter-patter, pitter-patter, so that they have a little bath. The children, of course, love to dunk it in many, many times, but too much water makes it a little overly saturated. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter, listen to the rain. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter, listen to the rain. And now the children will be rolling it in their hands. And then you can remind them, a gentle squeeze, just like the little bug that's snug in his rug, a gentle squeeze. And then you want to start to get a little firmer with your squeeze. And then it's very helpful, I find, especially for the youngest ones, that they start to work on a cloth. It helps to get the excess water out. And it's much easier for them to work with. Roly-poly rice ball, roll right in. Up the hill and down the hill and roll right in. And it does look like an egg very much, or a chubby little peanut. Now, I have just soapy water here, but you're going to want to have a bowl of warm, clean water as well, so that they can just do one more dip and a squeeze, holding it so tight. And then one last roll, but your hands won't be so soapy. Roly-poly rice ball, roll right in. Up the hill and down the hill and roll right in. And then they have the beginning of their little bunny ball.